So, you want to travel to Europe this summer, but maybe you're not sure which countries are open, safe, what are their entry requirements, but what about the requirements to go back home? Do you know how to plan your flexible and safe holiday? Don't worry, you don't need to know the answers of all these questions because I will tell you everything that you need to know before booking your holiday. And I'm saying this because I visited 3 countries last summer and I'm also planning on traveling this year. Hi guys, it's your curious and awkward friend VASI. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is VASI, I live in London and I love my city and I love also traveling. So if you want to see more of this content, but which is always informative and fun, don't forget to like this video and hit the subscribe bell button to join the curious gang. You guys, even before booking any holiday, you should think about 2 very important things. First of all, the entry requirements into the country where you're going, and also what are the requirements to come back to your home country. Let's start by addressing the big elephant in the room: which countries in Europe are both open and safe. I will start the situation for you American friends. I will tell you which countries you can visit because luckily for you, Europe has opened to vaccinated Americans. And here is the whole list of countries which you can visit here in Europe, just highlighting a couple. You can go to Greece, you can go to Cyprus, you can go to Montenegro, or you can go to my home country, Bulgaria. And another very common question is, can unvaccinated kids visit Europe? Would need a negative PCR test, which is taken at least 72 hours prior to your flight. And if you're traveling from the UK, I'm sure you already know how our traffic light system works, but let me explain a little bit for our friends that are not from the UK. Basically, you guys, if you live in the UK, the government kind of gives you already an advice on which countries are safe to visit. The ones on the green list are safe to travel to. The amber list are only open for essential travel. And then we have the red list, which we should definitely avoid. Also, according which color is the country, then you also have to do different requirements when you come back into the UK, but we will get into this. The funny thing in this whole situation is that the European countries are actually welcoming British citizens. However, the UK government doesn't really advise us on visiting those countries and has given us a list of 3 countries that we are allowed to visit: the Faroe Islands, Iceland and Gibraltar. And in my books, the first 2 are not really a summer destination, so we're left with only 1 at the moment, which is a little bit sad. But for anyone from the UK, you guys, I have tips for you on how to book your holidays, and we'll get into this in a bit.
And in case you're wondering if more countries are going to be added onto the green list, these are the countries that are expected to go onto the green list.
If you live in any of the European Union countries and you want to travel to another EU country, then you're quite in luck because those 2 like each other and they kind of share the same feeling. So also the requirements when you're traveling from one EU country to the other are quite similar. And you guys, let's start with how to book your flight, which is stress-free and flexible. Well, I really suggest you using the website of Skyscanner because it always gives you a very good vision of all the flights to your chosen destinations. And at the moment, they have also included this flexible tickets, which I really suggest you taking when you choose your flight, because the most important thing this summer, as I said, is staying flexible. I want to tell you that if you're booking with Ryanair at the moment, they have this policy that if you book any tickets before the 30th of September, you can change them with 0 fee. And the same thing also applies to British Airways. You can cancel your flight without paying any extra fee and you would get a voucher. Only company that I would definitely avoid, especially from the low-cost ones at the moment, is EasyJet, because I saw that they have
this big thing written on their website, which basically says that if something happens, then you're going to lose all your money from the flight. And let's move on to accommodation. Staying flexible is literally key. So always take free cancellation options, flexible tickets. Wherever you see this option within your search, always click that, because you just want to stay flexible. And yes, I know that this might mean that you won't get the best deal. Yes, maybe you will miss on some super cheap and convenient offer, but the cheapest option now at the moment might not always have the best value for money. And something that you should really keep in mind: until when actually can you cancel it for free? And I'm literally saying this from my own experience, because I booked one accommodation for this summer and I saw that at the moment I cannot cancel it for free. You can cancel it for free until like 1 month before you go, but after this period you still have to pay either the full amount or half of this money. So be really, really careful and read all those small letters that are written down there, because otherwise you won't be able to sleep at night.
I realized that I didn't tell you the most important message I had for you. Basically, I really suggest you and also kind of urge you, if you can, to stay at local small hotels and really help in any possible way that you can small and local businesses.
Because, you know, 2020 was already hard enough on small and especially family-owned businesses, so we can help them with whatever we can. And continuing with
more useful tips for you. Well, first of all, the most important thing for me whenever I book something at the moment is having the peace of mind that it is flexible. And something which I like doing is writing down the date until when I can get this refund and it can be cancelled for free. Just in case something happens, I can immediately go straight away and request back my money. And something else quite important, which many companies have actually started doing, is whenever you book your flight, you can actually get a COVID coverage. I found this company which covers both if anything happens like COVID related and you want to cancel your trip, but it also has medical insurance. You guys, if you're from the UK and you want to travel this year, I came up with this. Listen, so the best solution and something which personally I'm doing is create a list of the places where you would like to go this year.
And make this list very, very detailed. Write exactly the place where you would like to stay, put there the hotel that you have chosen, or even go ahead and book a flexible ticket if you know that you can cancel it for free. And do this with a couple of countries. So in case the country of your first choice goes into the amber list, then you can go ahead into the second place you have chosen and go ahead and directly book that instead. And very important, once you arrive in your holiday destination, don't forget to support local businesses.
And a couple of ways in which you can support local businesses is that if you choose the activities from Airbnb Experience or Get Your Guide, usually those things are organized by individuals and not by big companies. So that's an amazing way to support the local business.
Lastly, let's see what happens when you go back to your home country. If you're from the US and even if you have a vaccine, you should still provide a negative PCR test. However, if you have been to Europe and you want to come back into the UK, well, pretty much all of Europe is within the amber list of countries. You should first of all complete a passenger's locator form. You had to fill it in 2020 and it just takes you like 5 or 10 minutes and you just need your passport to do that. Basically, if you're coming from a green list country, first of all, you're allowed to travel, and then you should do a pre-departure lateral flow test, which is basically the rapid test that you do and you get your results in like usually 20 minutes. Most importantly, you don't have to quarantine, and you only need to do a PCR test on the second day after you arrive. If you're coming from a number country, first of all, you should not travel unless it is essential. You should self-isolate for 10 days and after that do two PCR tests on day 2 after your arrival and also on day 8. Red list country, which, oh my god, you guys, it's giving me a headache just thinking about it. And you should self-isolate within a government hotel for 10 days, which are quite expensive. They cost like £2,000 for 10 days. Such a headache. Let me know in the comments down below, are you planning to travel this year? Love you all. Bye.
You guys, I will see you in this next video from Greece.